Page 6 to 10 of your guide to know the timings. We have exciting keynotes lined up first thing tomorrow morning, which you definitely don't want to miss. So plan your travel such that you beat Bangalore traffic and join us on time. Thank you. Our next speaker for today will be Mr. Vijay Pandey. He'll be speaking on the session Quality Engineering. Mr. Vijay Pandey is an architect with Sapient Razorfish and Android mobile application development expert. He's currently leading the QSR-based mobile projects and helping, mentoring, and motivating developers to follow industry-proven architecture or design pattern and best practice. We welcome you, Mr. Vijay Pandey.
Thank you so much. So, what a lovely introduction. Thank you so much. So, as already covered that, the topic is quality engineering, SIP left philosophy. So, first of all, I would like to know that how many of you are mobile developer? Great. And, okay, so this session is going to talk about the quality engineering, and especially for the mobile folks, for the who is developing the things, developing mobile app. So, before moving, just wanted to express my emotional things that what happens when we get some error and what happens, it is quite painful when we get any production error. So I'm just going to display one video which gives the agenda of this session. So this video indicates that how we are facing problems while solving the issues, bugs in production. So it is quite painful as a mobile developer, as any developer, we work hard and we somehow miss something. So there must be some reason that why something missed, why we have not catched those bugs, those issues while our development. So we will talk about what is the current world problem. So basically, so the main concern of the developer is, anybody have any idea that what is the main concern? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, correct. Thank you. So the thing is, if something misses, and as a mobile, we got the crashes. App crash is the biggest concern for the mobile developer. Then regression, obviously. No time for reviews. If I have I have developed my own module, so it must be reviewed, and as a peer review, I must have time to review for some others module as well. So this is one of the concerns. And the device fragmentation is the biggest concern for the mobile industry. So the life cycle of app somewhat starts when we have deployed the app on the app store. As a user, someone is downloaded, he finds it useful, it's okay. And if he doesn't, then he just, so simple phenomena, download the things, if it is useful, it is in peak performance, and once decline, and it is buggy, and it is something not helpful, then it is no use of it, and very slightly it goes in vain. User just uninstall it, forget it. Life cycle of app is only from there. So what is the biggest complexities, basically? So device fragmentation is the biggest, as I have already cover this. So device fragmentation, do we have any information that what is the different devices we have in all the smartphones? So there are more than 46,000 devices available in the market. So this is the biggest concern, and they have a number of different OS versions as well. Nowadays, basically, everyone wants to make the app faster, releases faster, get the feedback faster, so that it can be useful for many users. Also, the biggest challenge that there are large number of teams working together. So there are collaborations issues we often found. Many times it happens that there is not clarity of the business, what they are going to present, and many more such complexities we have. So if we talk about the methodologies, whether it is waterfall, whether it is agile, or any spiral, or any methodologies which is used for the development of the app projects. So it is simply that it is just gather the requirement, design it, start developing, and hand over it to testers. Tester gives the feedback, it raises the issues. And if everything is fine, then it goes to production. What happens if something changes? Some change comes. So sometimes it is very tough to handle the change expectations, change in requirement, and which gives the negative outcomes. Negative outcomes means the it takes time for the delivery. It takes, again, lots of research and development for the developer that something has changed, how I'm going to modify this. So what happens, the thing, we have some kind of model like this. Initially we start, but at the end, when it goes to the testers, they have huge number of defects with their hands, which creates lots of issues for the for all the prospective, whether it is a developer mindset, whether it is a tester's mindset, or PM, or anyone. So it becomes a huge challenge that something happens from the beginning, but when it comes to the particular tester or particular validations, then it fails. It fails, okay? So what is the issues of the quality assurance find? So when it becomes, as I have depicted here, that when it goes to the testers, it has huge number of testing functionalities. So what happens? They find the defect in delay. There is a higher number of effort they found. And there is no benefit of automation. And many times it happens that as a developer, I have developed my module, I'm right, I'm correct. Same goes to the testers. He has written his own test script, he's also right. But when build releases, it goes to the final testing, that something misses, that requirement is not correct, design is not correct. So lots of regression issues we get. So here, how we can solve these problems? So we can introduce shiplift philosophy here. So basically, by using shiplift philosophy, okay, let me ask some questions. Anybody has any idea that what is shiplift philosophy? Okay. So I have some questions. So if I ask, it is going to provide automation. It is correct. Shift left philosophy is an automation. It is going to promote. It is correct or wrong? Pardon? Okay, so it is a kind of process. So if I say that it is not automation kind of thing, it is correct. Okay, great. So if I ask that, is it unit testing? Is shift left philosophy, if it is, as we are getting lots of defects at the end of the cycle, so can be related with the, it is a unit testing, it is going to provide more flexibility on the unit testing. It is right or wrong? Yes or no? Yes? So luckily it is also not. It is not just about the unit test as well. And also it is not just about the DevOps that it is going to do anything for the DevOps. And the main thing is that it is not replacing the quality assurance. Okay, so what does shift mean? So it is simple. Start testing as soon as you start developing. Means that as a developer, I'm the responsible for the quality of my module. I'm only responsible. And if you do some Google, then you will find lots of data that currently Facebook and Amazon, they are saying that we can rely on developers. There is no testing required. We rely on the developers. So what is this? This is a kind of mindset. That as a developer, I am going to own it. I'm the responsible for the quality of my module, which is going to turn to provide the quality of my projects. Okay? And if we have started testing along with developer, along with development, what it gives? It gives me the faster releases. Okay? So we can relate it like what we have discussed, that this model, if we use this approach, that once project is incepted, we are going to test as well as develop as well as test. So it will become like this. Initially, you are going to get lots of bugs, lots of things, which is while development phase of the life cycle, you can get many things, many defects, many things which makes your module, which makes your project easier for the production. It goes from top to decline. Okay, so means there was one case study I read, basically. So in that case study, I found that which part of the life cycle we can get lots of defects. Any idea? So which phases, means whether it is testing, whether it is a requirement, whether it is deployment. Okay, so rate of defects. Rate of defects related with which phase, basically. So the answer is that most of the defects are related with requirement and designing. There are around 7% related with the coding. So Okay, so this is somewhat, okay, so let me take one pause. Let me ask some question. So, let me ask one more question again, because how many of you are mobile developer? And how many QA? Rest of the people related with the mobile somehow. Means as a user as well, because mobile user is the best source. Okay, so how many of you love to write unit testing? Okay, number is somewhat, okay. It's a part, yeah, definitely as a developer, it's a developer mindset. I was a developer, okay? So it is kind of extra thing. It is taking, let's finish my module, let's deploy it. I will write this unit testing later, okay? And this later becomes huge. Then we have to spend our weekends, okay? Okay, so unit test and integration testing, and there are manual testing. As a developer, we do the manual testing. I have tested everything is okay, great. So if we relate this, then we can find that this is what is our structure. Okay? So the base is somewhat unit testing, then integration, GUI testing, manual testing. And what this is called, basically this is called the ice cream cone model. This means we are compromising with quality. We are compromising with quality because we know as a developer, sometimes we enforce, I will write this later, let this, but it means somewhat we are compromising the quality, which becomes our mindset. What happens next time? So if it becomes our mindset, so definitely today if we are compromising 10% and we have finished this, 90% is correct. Next day what happens? We are going to compromising 10%, 90 minus 10. So we are decreasing the things. We are compromising with the quality. Here, and when it goes to the production or later stage of the life cycle, it is very tough to manage the code. Whether it is code quality, whether it is unit testing, whether it is Git branching, or anything related with the development. Okay? So how we can solve this problem? We can transition the ice cone model to pyramid model. Okay, so in this approach, Siplet philosophy says that we can just make it opposite. Let's do the unit test, not only the unit test, let's do the automated unit test, okay? Here we can get, we can focus larger stage of development cycle, we can have multiple builds. So, okay, what happens if we go to compare with waterfall model? We have a waterfall model, we have a agile methodology. So in waterfall model, what happens? Everything, it goes one by one. Development completed, then it goes, requirement completed, then goes to designing, then goes to testing. So tester gets the build at least 1 week or 2 weeks later. This means this solves the problem when agile came into the picture, then what happens? It breaks the things into epic, sprint, backlog, okay? So in sprint, there are 10 stories, develop this, and release the build to the QA, and QA, if you have developed this, as soon as QA will test it, and he will give the his feedback, whether it is feedback in terms of bugs or in terms of anything which he loves. Loves means that maybe critical, maybe major, maybe minor. Okay, so then we identify. It means waterfall model, it takes longer time, but agile methodology, it reduces the time, but the time it is also taking. Okay, so shift left philosophy says, can it be possible if I immediately develop and immediately it get tested, so that we immediately get the information whether my code is correct, it is going to fulfill all the requirements, all the definition of doneness. If I say definition of doneness means that before releasing it to the QA, whether it is going to satisfy all the benchmark which is required for my module. So here we are just going to transition from quality assurance to quality engineering. So we are not replacing quality assurance. I'm saying here, keep this word, quality. We are not replacing this quality assurance to quality, we are not replacing quality assurance, sorry. So we are just transitioning, quality assurance to quality engineering. Okay, so that we can get immediate feedback, we can get immediate actions, what is required for the developers. So basically what this is a kind of mindset shift. As a developer, earlier, I was only responsible for developing of my module. Now, I'm taking extra responsibility. I will test my code as well. Okay? So it is just a mindset shift. So here, developers are the quality owners. So what does it mean by this? They are going to learn new technologies. New technologies which is related with the automation. Okay? And they should understand the principle of automation so that they can write their code, and this code can be used for the automation. Okay? Because if I have write code in any manner, whether there are many tools which supports the automation, how they are going to adopt it. So they must know the tools and the skills, the technologies which supports the automation. So they are the responsible for quality. So the question arises here, so everything is developer are going to do, then what test engineers will do? And I have already communicated that shift left philosophy is not replacing the quality assurance. So test engineers, definitely, they are also shifting left. They are going to enhance automation and provide the rapid feedback. Okay, what happens as a tester? I'm a tester. I have written, okay, there is a one module, and what this module, developers and test, the developer is developing the things and tester is writing the test cases so that he can verify the use cases and all the things, and tester is developing, and so here tester and developer both have different mindset. Tester is developing what he understands. Tester is testing what he has got the requirement from the specification. So now, what is this? I'm going to talk about the collaboration. As I have already mentioned that, developer is going to make his code automated so that it can be automated, and that code tester is going to use to adopt the automation. So tester can learn the new skills like new automation script, okay? So basically it gives a better collaboration that both testers and developers can make this forward, and any organization can get a much more benefit from this philosophy. Okay. So, this one? Okay, so, okay, got your point. So, this is basically, you are talking about this, right? So, basically this is quality assurance to quality engineering means. So, earlier, means QA person doesn't have any relations with the development, okay? But now quality engineering says, testers should know what is Xcode, what is Android Studio, and how to use the charts, how to use the Stato so that they can verify the APIs and all other things. So it is somewhat technical perspective. Okay? By the way, that was a good question. Right. Right. Okay. Yeah. Automation does not. Okay. Can I finish so that we can talk later? Don't worry. Okay. So here I'm going to, because we have he is showing the 5 minutes we have. So it is how we have implemented Cypress philosophy in our organization, Cypress Razor phase. So we have converted our layered architecture pattern to the Lego blocks, where we have just creating the modules. Same module can be used for iOS and Android as well. And we are using various tools and frameworks. Both developers and testers are aware of it. And here, I would like to focus here that now we have changed our methodologies that if we are onboarding any developers, then there are some mandatory training we provide them so that they should know that what is CI and CD processes and what is a Sonar Cube and how the app is stored and what is a device lab so that it can be managed on multiple devices, okay? And also, developer and testers and should know what is the PM process, estimation tools. If they know that if they are doing, they are going to develop some stories, then they have the clear picture that what is the estimated time they need to do it. Okay, and they must aware this Jira flow and dashboard. If I say dashboard, then this is basically a kind of dashboard which collaborated with all the defects and all the required things so that everybody can get the information that particular story or particular module has this kind of deficiency or this kind of problem so that they can use it and they can amend it. And we are motivating, our developers and testers so they should aware what is the DevOps process and the responsibilities of developers and track leads and DevOps people. And also we have a kind of recognitions and rewards, so that it's the kind of motivation that why should they move towards quality engineering? Why they should learn new things for the testing, automation, or anything which comes into for the quality engineering area. Okay, so we just motivate them and have some processes to recognize their effort when they are doing any module, and it is best pass rate, and there is no there is no regression, and code coverage is best. Then we provide them a kind of. So it is not a just thing. There are many things we have. So due to time constraint. So the motto of development, our first code should be the best code. This is the whole shift-left philosophy is going to say. So motivation should be to adopt this mindset, so that first code should be the best code. So we have implemented kind of demos, but here, because due to lack of time out, I just explained the things that quickly. So the what we have implemented, we are using the Git, and what is the if something is wrong, then we do not allow code to push to the Git, there are various processes we have already implemented in our organization. So thank you. That's all.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing the information with us. I request everyone to put your hands together for Vijay Pandey, sir.
Thank you.